Hello everyone, this is Rizaşçelik. Today I will present you CanBoost, a chemical language-based approach for drug target affinity prediction. CanBoost is developed with my co-authors Hakim Öztürk, Arjun Özgür, and Elif Özkırımlı, and was previously published in the Journal of Molecular Informatics. Here, in CanBoost, we want to accelerate the drug discovery process, which is known as a long and expensive one. Drug discovery pipelines can take up to 15 years and $2 billion to complete. It is a multi-step pipeline that includes molecular design and clinical and preclinical studies and ends with an approval process. In the drug discovery in general, we want to develop compounds that are effective on a target and show some high affinity with the target. And to accelerate the process, we want to actually find high affinity pairs, high affinity compound and protein pairs, and we want to find them fast. For instance, luckily, we have some information in the literature in the form of compound pair and affinity score triplets. For instance, we know that compound 1 binds with protein 3 with the affinity score of 8, and compound 3 binds with protein 2 with the affinity score of 7. And we would like to ask the question, what would be the affinity between a compound 3 and protein 3, let's say. But this is a difficult question to answer, actually, because we have around 2 million bioactive compounds in Campbell and hundreds of thousands of proteins in SwissProt that we can use as targets. So we simply have too many combinations to experiment with in vitro. What we can do is, though, use computational methods to search this combination space in a fast way. More specifically, we can use machine learning for affinity prediction to ask the question we would like to ask. With the machine learning, we can ask the following question, which we were desiring. Given a list of compound and protein pairs with these affinity scores, what would be the affinity of this compound protein pair? With machine learning, we can ask this question very naturally. And CanBoost is a machine learning method, which is based on the chemical language, and it aims to predict the affinity between any drug target pair. CanBoost uses two channels to represent proteins and ligands, and uses a prediction algorithm called XGBoost to predict the affinity between any protein compound pair. So now let's discuss each of these protein ligand channels more in detail, and let's start with the ligand channel. To represent ligands, we use a special syntax called Simplified Molecular Input Line Entry System, or SMILE strings. SMILE strings are specially designed syntax that encode the 2D information about the ligand and also in 1D space. So SMILE language, since they have a special syntax, they actually encode a language that we call as chemical language. And we hypothesize that we can process this chemical language as if it is a natural language and use natural language methodologies to process ligand and learn ligand representations. And we view these SMILE strings as documents in this chemical language we would like to process. But then a natural question arises, actually. If SMILE is a document, then where are the words? Because in natural language, we have words and we can use them to represent sentences or documents, let's say. But with SMILEs, these words are initially hidden. So let's find them. To find the words of a ligand, or a SMILE string, we use ATMER approach. In the ATMER approach, we extract the list of all 8 character subsequences of a SMILE string. For instance, we extract the first 8 character of the SMILE string and then slide the window 1 right and extract the next 8 character sequence, and then slide 1 right more and then extract the next character, next A character sequence. We continue until we reach the end of the semester string, and when we reach the end, then we obtain a list of chemical words that we can use to represent the document or ligand. And for word representation, we use the word-to-vec algorithm, which is developed to represent natural words in natural languages. Word-to-vec can use semantically meaningful word representations for each word, and we hope that it can also learn semantically meaningful chemical word representations in our chemical language. To do so, we train word-to-vec algorithm on a corpus of 2 million smiles created from Campbell, and then train the algorithm and obtain a chemical word vector for each chemical word we have encountered. But again, our goal was to represent ligands, not the words only. And to represent the ligands, we simply compute the average of each word vector in a smile string. And we call this vector as the smiles vec of this ligand, and use this smiles vec to represent the ligand. Okay. So to sum up our ligand representation, we first identify the words of a smiles string with HMR technique, and then use word-to-vec algorithm to learn word vector representations, and then use these word vectors to create a smiles vec for the ligand and represent the ligand with the smiles vec vector. Now let's discuss the protein representation. To represent the proteins, we use their amino acid sequences. But we also know that amino acid sequences have some deficiencies. Amino acid representations have some deficiencies. For instance, we know that a similarity of amino acid sequences does not always imply the functional similarity of proteins and vice versa. And here we are interested in the functional proteins, functional properties of the proteins, so we want to encode this information in a successful way. To do so, we develop a method called ligand-centric protein representation. In the ligand-centric protein representation, we represent each protein with its known ligands. And to represent a protein with its ligands, we simply compute the smiles vec representations of the ligands and then take their average to obtain a ligand-centric protein vector. This vector encodes the functional information of a protein directly because it uses its interacting ligands. And we also develop some variations of these methods where we use only high affinity ligands to represent the proteins or all of its ligands, or integrating an external resource to enrich the known high affinity ligands. We also benchmark our representation, ligand-centric representation, with ProtVec and Smith-Waterman vectors from the literature. We then design experiments where we concatenated these vectors or experimented them as standalone representations and deduced some results. For our experimental setup, we use two data sets, which are BDB and Kiba. Here, the important thing is that Kiba contains much more ligands than per protein than BDB. And it means that it actually can present more information for ligand-centric representations. We use five-fold cross-validation for experiments and evaluate the models with respect to their mean squared error and concordance index. We then run some experiments and deduce the following results. We find that using only high affinity ligands of a protein is a more effective way for the drug target affinity prediction task to represent proteins. Because the models we developed that differ only by this aspect, we developed models that differ only by this aspect, and we found that strong binding, using only strong binding ligands, yields higher scores across data sets in terms of both metrics. We also experimented with incorporating an external database to our strong binding ligands and found out that this improves performance on BDB, but does not create any significant statistic result on Kiba. We relate this with the fact that Kiba contained much more ligand per protein and could already present sufficient information to represent a protein. Last, we experiment with some hybrid representations where we use both ligand-centric representations and Smith-Waterman to represent a protein and use Smith-Waterman as a standalone representation, and find that using hybrid representations yield more consistent results across datasets and metrics. Then, having observed the performance of CanBoost under several setups, we compared CanBoost with some known methods in the literature. We used CoronaLS, SimBoost, and DeepDTA as our benchmarks and found out that CanBoost outperforms CoronaLS and SimBoost on both datasets and is on par with DeepDTA in both datasets. Here, the important note is that DeepDTA is a deep learning model that based on convolutions and fully connected neural networks and uses smile strings and amino acid sequences only. But CanBoost could still achieve the level of DeepDTA by using a less complex predictor, and thus it actually uses more powerful representations such as SmilesVec and ligand-centric protein representation. So thank you for listening.